Before 7.3, wait a minute. Yes, let's start practice set 7.3. Okay, so all of you are ready? Yes, so you have learned the formulas, area of a sector, length of the arc, all these definitions and formulas you have learned, correct? Now you have to solve the practice set 7.3. So you are ready? Share. Okay, let's see. Okay. Our first question is, radius of a circle is 10 centimeter. Measure of an arc of the circle is 54 degree. Find the area of the sector associated with the arc. Is it clear? Means what is given that you should know. Okay. So can you tell me what is given now? But I can see the screen. Yes, my screen is visible to you. Screen is visible to you or not? Yes, many students are saying the screen is visible. Yes. Okay. So screen is visible, beta. Check your network. Okay. Okay, let's see what is given first of all. Okay, now radius is 10 centimeter, measure of the arc, that is theta, is 54 degree. What we have to find? We have to find area of a sector. Now, area of a sector, formula. Write the formula, area of a sector, fast. Area of a sector. Yes, theta upon 360 pi r square. Okay. Sanskriti Sulse have given the answer. Riya, Diksha. Okay. Arya. Hiral. Okay, good. So area of a sector is equal to theta upon 360 into pi r square, correct? Let's see now. Okay, radius is given, theta is given. Okay, what we have to find? We have to write area of a sector, then solution, then we have to write the formula. Okay, and you know the formula very well. Square is there, pi r square is there. Okay, theta upon 360 into pi r square is written. So now we have to substitute the value 54 upon 360 into 3.14 into 10 square. Square is written, but it is very small. So it is 10 square. Okay. Now substitute 18 into 3. 54, we have taken the factor of 54, 18 into 3. And for 360, we have taken the factor 18 into 20. So you understood what will cancel. Correct, na? 18, 18 will be cancel. So what will remain? 3 upon 20 into 100 into 3.14. Now 20 into 5. 100. Correct? 25 are 100. So what will come now? 3 into 5 into 3.14. 3 into 5 into 1.4. Correct? So 3 into 5, 15. 15 into 3.14. Okay. So what will be the final answer now? Yes, 47.1 centimeter square. So we can write in this way. The area of the sector is 47.1 centimeter square. Is it clear? Okay, let's move to the second question. Okay, measure of an arc of a circle. Measure of an arc of a circle is 80 degree and its radius is 18 centimeter. Find the length of the arc when pi is 3.14. When pi, value of pi is given, that value you have to take. And suppose the value of pi is not given, on that time you have to take 22/7. Is it clear? And when it is specifies that, take the value of pi as 3.14, on that time you have to take the value of pi is equal to 3.14. Is it clear? So can you tell me what is given here now? First, radius is given, theta is given. Correct? Radius is 18 centimeter, theta is 80 degree. Now what we have to find? We have to find length of the arc. What we have to find? Length of the arc. Now can you tell me what is the formula of length of the arc? First, what is the formula of length of the arc? Because we have to find length of the arc, so we should know the formula of length of the arc. Correct? So write down length of the arc. Okay. Good. Yes, many students are writing the formula. Very good. But the same name is coming. At least those who have taken part in the activity, they can write, na? Okay, length of the arc, theta upon 360 into 2 pi r. What is that? Length of the arc, theta upon 360 into 2 pi r. Only one time 2 pi r will be there. Two time it is not there. Okay. How many times is there? One time. Okay. So length of the arc is equal to theta upon 360 into 2 pi r. Okay. Now substitute the value. What is theta? 80 degree. 360 into 2 into 3.14 into 80. Correct? See properly. Theta is 80. So 80 upon 360 into 2. In the formula 2 pi r, 2 is there. The value of pi is 3.14 and then r. R is radius, which is given. Okay, now cancel, divide 0 and 0. Correct? What is that? 0, 0 you can cancel. Okay, so what will remain now? 8 upon 36 and multiply this. Two into 18 is what? 36, correct? So now you can multiply in this way. 8 upon 36 into 36 into 3.14. Now 36 will cancel. Because 36 divided by 36 is equal to 1. Okay, so what will remain when 36 is cancelled? Yes, very good. Very good. So 8 into 3.14, correct? 8 into 3.14 when 36 will cancel. Then 8 into 3.14, just multiply it. Multiply fast. 8 into 3.14, yes, very good. Yes. So length of the arc is 25.12 centimeter. Here it will come centimeter because length of the arc is measured in centimeter. Okay. Now length of the arc is 25.12 centimeter. Is it clear? Okay. Now come to the question number 3. Radius of the sector of a circle is 3.5 centimeter. radius, it is radius is given. And length of its arc is 2.2 centimeter. Find the area of the sector. Is it clear? Okay. Now let's see what is given. You can also write what is given. Yes. Sanskriti, Diksha, they are writing the answer. So here, radius is given 3.5 centimeter and length of the arc is given 2.2 centimeter. Length of the arc is given. Now we have to find the area of a sector. So what will be the formula for the area of a sector? Yes, correct. Preeti. Correct. Riddhi also. I want that every student should take part in this. Everyone have mobile or computer. Correct, huh? Means something is there. So you can write in that also. Write in chat box. You can see my name is there. So you can send the message. So that I also know that you are studying at home. So we will, what we have to find? We have to find the area of a sector. Now, as you have written the formulas, many students, all students, not many, all students have written correctly. That is L upon, that is L upon 2 into R. So area of a sector is equal to L upon 2 into R. 2 is denominator, 2 is present at denominator and R is at numerator. L upon 2. So 2 is present at denominator and R is present at numerator. So there should be no confusion between the area of a sector formula. Now we can substitute the value. As we know that length is given 2.2 upon 2 into 3.5. Area of a sector is equal to L upon 2 into R. So that is 2.2 into 2, 2.2 upon 2 into 3.5. So when 2.2 is divided by 2, what will remain? 1.1. Correct? 1.1 into 3.5. 1.1 into 3.5. Now multiply fast. Bhumi and Neha. Siddesh. So it is 3.85 centimeter square. 3.85 centimeter square. Shall we move to the next question now? Let's see the next question. That is fourth one. Radius of a circle is 10 centimeter. Area of a sector of the circle is 100 centimeter square. Find the area of its corresponding major sector. So we have to find here area of a major sector. Clear cut mention. What that? It is mentioned that find the area of the corresponding major sector. Means find the area of major sector. Correct? But before that, we have to see that what are the other things given to find the area of major sector. So let's see. You can also write. So that I also know that you are known or familiar with the formula properly. So radius is given. Radius is given 10 centimeter. Area of a minor sector is given. That is 100 centimeter square. 100 centimeter square. Area of a minor sector is what? 100 centimeter square. Now what we have to find? We have to find the area of a major sector. we have to find the area of a major sector. Now, to find the area of a major sector, we have to find the area of a circle first, and then from the area of a circle, we have to subtract the minor sector. Then only area of a major sector can be found easily. Okay, is it clear? Sure. Shall we see now? Okay, let's see solution of this question. So area of a circle, that is pi r square. Area of a circle is what? Pi r square. Square is there, huh? Pi r square. So 3.14 into 10 raised to 2. That is square. Okay. Square is written. But yes. So substitute the value. The value of pi is given in the question itself. 3.14 into the value of r is given. 10 square. So 10 square is what? 100. So 3.14 into 100. What will happen now? Yes. Multiply it now with the 100. A point will move to the left side, right side. When there is a multiplication, point will move to the right side. So when point will move to the right side, it becomes 314 centimeter square, means 314 centimeter square. Is it clear? 314 centimeter square, area of a circle, 314 centimeter square. Now we have to find the area of a major sector. We have to find the area of a major sector. So area of a major sector is equal to area of a circle minus area of a minor sector. So area of circle is what? 340. What is the area of minor sector? That is 100. So 340 minus 100. That is equal to 240. Okay, you can see the formula. I have substituted, okay. Then at the end, we have to write the area of the corresponding major sector is 214 centimeter square. Is it clear? Sure. Okay. We'll move to our next question. That is question number 6. Question number 6. Okay. Question number 6. Let's see what is the question number 6. Now a diagram is given. In the adjoining figure, radius of the circle is 7 cm and major arc MBN is 60 degree. Okay. So area of a circle pi r square, the value of r is given 7 square, that is 7 into 7. Okay. And value of pi is 22 upon 7. So 17 will cancel. 17 will cancel. 17 will cancel. What will remain? 22 into 7. So multiply it and you will get the answer. That is 154 centimeter square. Okay. So the area of the circle is 154 centimeter square. Now second, area of sector OMBN. Area of sector OMBN. Okay. So central angle is given. That is angle MON, 60 degree in the question. It is diagram. In the diagram question, it is mistake. So, but the theta is 60 degree. In the diagram, it is 68. It is written. That is wrong. Theta is 60 degree. Okay. Theta is 60 degree. So area of a sector is equal to area of a sector is equal to theta upon 360 into pi r square. Okay, we know what is pi r square. Pi r square is the area of a circle. Correct? Pi r square is a area of a circle. Correct. That is 154. That is 154. Yes, correct. Sanskriti, Bhumi, Siddesh, Neha, all have written properly. Very good. Very good. So, 60 upon 360, let's see. So, area of a sector, 60 upon 360 into 154. So, all of you know 150 from where 154 came. Correct, na? So, 0, 0 is cancelled. So, it remained 1 upon 6. Correct? 1 upon 6 into 154. Okay? 1 upon 6 into 54. Is it clear? Okay. Now divide by 3. 3 twos are 6. Divide by 3. Okay. So you can divide by 3. 3, 3 will cancel. Okay. So what will remain? 2 from 2, it will cancel. 154 is 2 into 2 into 77. 54, we have taken the factor of 154. We have taken the factor of 154. That is 2 into 77. And factor of 6 is 2 into 3. So 2, 2 will cancel. This 2 and this 2 cancel. So what remained? 77 upon 3. Is it clear? Now divide 77 by 3. Divide first. Take your own time. Divide it in your notebook and then write. Okay. 25.67. Correct. 25.67 centimeter square. Is it clear? Okay. Then you can round up also. No problem is there. If you are round up in tens, it becomes 25.7 centimeter square. At the end, we can write area of a sector OMBN is 25.7 centimeter square. Okay. Now, third part. Area of a major sector is equal to area of a circle minus area of a minor sector. So we know the area of a circle, we know the area of minor sector. Both we know. Just substitute the value. Yes, Bhumi, correct. Substitute the value. But for minor sector, Bhumi have written wrong. Minor sector. Yes, Bhumi. So you have to write 154 minus 25.7. Okay. 154 minus 25.7. Now subtracting. What you will get? Yes. Area of OMCN is equal to 128.3. Okay. Centimeter. Is it clear? Shall we move to the next question now? Sure. Okay. Let's see. Yes, you can see the diagram. Yes or no? You can see the diagram, no? So, yeah. So let's see the question now. In the given figure, O is the center of the sector. What is O? O is the center of the sector. And angle ROQ is 60 degree. And angle MON is also 60 degree. OR is the radius. OR is equal to OQ is equal to 7 centimeter. And OM is equal to ON is equal to 21 centimeter. Find the length of arc. Rxq. You can see Rxq and arc MYN. Here we have to take the value of pi as 22 upon 7. Is it clear? So what you are going to do for this? Tell me now. What you are going to find first? Yes, length of the arc. Correct. We are going to find length of the arc Rxq. Okay? Because everything is given. Theta is given, radius is given. Just you have to write the formula of length of the arc. Can you tell me what is that? Yes, very good. Khushi have written, Sanskriti have written. Okay, Drishti also, today writing. Okay, good. So, let's see what is given. You have to write, huh? Okay, without fail, you have to write what is given. So, R, angle ROQ is equal to angle MON is equal to 60 degree. Okay, same angle with different name. Now, radius is given. OR is 7 centimeter. Here, OR we have taken small r, 7 centimeter, and OM we have taken as a capital R, which is 21 centimeter. Okay. Now, what we have to find? We have to find length of the arc RXQ and arc MYN. Okay. So, let's see the solution of this. So, length of the arc, first of all, formula. Length of the arc Rxq is equal to theta upon 362 into 2 pi r. Okay. So, how we are going to divide it? Now the question arises. Correct? So, you have to see that it 60 upon 360 into 2 into 22 upon 7 into 7. 22 upon 7. 7 is present denominator. So, 7, 7 will cancel. 60 upon 360 in that 0, 0 will cancel. Okay. First step we will do like this way. So, we have cancelled 0, 0 and we have cancelled 7. Correct? Two step we have done. Okay. We have cancelled 0 and we have cancelled 7. So, what remains? 6 upon 36 into 2 into 22. Okay. So 6 are 36 means 1 upon 6. In next step, we will write in this way 1 upon 6 into 2 into 22. I have taken small steps so that you can understand properly. Okay. You can do directly also, no problem is there. But I have taken small steps so that you understood. What happens many times, many students ask, sir, how you have divided, which number divided by which number. So, I have mentioned clearly here. Okay. Now, because here 1 upon 6 is there, so 2 into 3, 6. So, 2, 2 will cancel. Okay. From here, 2 and from here 2. This will cancel. So what will remain? 1 upon 3 into 22. What will remain? 1 upon 3 into 22. So 1 is multiplied by 22. Means 22 upon 3. Correct? Now you can divide it first. Divide. Divide first. 22 upon 3. Okay? So, we will get 7.33. Is it clear? Okay. Up to here, all of you understood? Sure. Okay, let's move to the next question now. Okay. Length of the arc MYN. So again, same formula, theta upon 360 into 2 pi r. Okay, the value of theta is given, the value of r is also given. So we will substitute 60 upon 360 into 22 upon 7 into 21. Okay, so what we will cancel now here? We will cancel this 7 3s are. Okay, so what we'll get? 1 upon 6 into 2 into 22 into 3. So if you multiply this 2 and this 2, you will get 6. So 6 will cancel. In the next step, we have cancelled 6. Okay. This 6 and this 6 is cancelled now. So what will remain? 22 centimeters. So at the end, we will write. What we will write? Length of the arc RXQ and length of the arc MY and R 7.33 centimeter and 22 centimeter respectively. Okay. Now, next question now. 12th question. Okay. Is it clear now? Up to here you understood properly. So, quadrilateral PQRS is a rectangle. If PQ is 14 centimeter, PQ is what? 14 centimeter. QR is 21 centimeter. Find the area of the parts given X, Y, Z. Okay. X and Y forming an area of a sector. Remember it. Forming an area of a sector. If you see here, rectangle is there, so a 90 degree will form. Property of a rectangle. And OP is given. QP is given. QP is 14 centimeter. Here it is 14 centimeter. PQ is 14 centimeter. So here also up to here it is 14 centimeter. Okay. What it is? 14 centimeter. Okay, let's start now. First of all, we will write given in rectangle PQRS. In rectangle PQRS, PQ is given. What is PQ? 14 centimeter. QR is what? 21 centimeter. You can see here, only one radius is, one PQ is given, correct? But here this, suppose we can take any variable here. Okay. Suppose we'll take R and A. Okay. What we will take? A here. What we will take? A. Now QR is given 21 centimeter, QA is 14 centimeter, then what will be RA? Yes, Bhumi, correct. What will be RA? Let's see now. Okay, what we have to find? We have to find the areas of the parts X, Y, Z. Okay, let's see. I have given a diagram to you so that you should not forget what is given. But I have taken separate diagram also of area of a sector. A sector is drawn, that is QPA. Correct? In the sector QPA, here QP is 14 and QA is also 14. Correct? So radius is 14. So how you are going to solve now? As we know that angle Q is 90 degree. Angle of a rectangle, Q is 90 degree angles of rectangle. So area of the part X, or we can say area of a sector where X is present. Okay, area of a sector. Now, so what is the area of a sector? Can you tell me now? Yes, area of a sector is equal to theta upon 360 into pi r square. Okay, is it clear? Okay, now substitute the value theta upon 360, 22 upon 7, and PQ square. PQ square, we know that it is radius. So 14 square. What will come? 14 square. 14 square means what? 14 into 40. So it will divide by 7. Correct? 7 twos are 40. Okay. So here 4 is there. From 4 also, 2 twos are 4. 2 sevens are 14. Okay. And then this 7 and this 7 will cancel. Okay. You can see here. 1 upon 4 was present, so it becomes 1 upon 2 into 22 is divided here. So it becomes 11 and 7 twos are 14. 7 twos are 14. Okay. Now 2, 2 will cancel here. These 2 and these 2 cancel. Okay. So what will remain? 11 into 14. So 11 into 14 is what? 154. Riddhi, correct. Yes, Riddhi, it is correct. 11 into 54, 154 centimeter square. Now we have to find the area of part. Next part, correct? That is for sector QPA. QPA that we have done. PQ is equal to PQ is equal to QA. Okay. Neeraj, what happened, beta? Which question? Which step you want to repeat? Okay, 11 into 14. You have to multiply. Okay, then you will get the answer. Every step I have mentioned, small step also I have mentioned. Yes, we have to complete. Today we have to complete. Anyhow, we have to complete. Tomorrow is also there. We can talk tomorrow also. No problem is there. Correct? Because our activity is on Monday. So we can talk tomorrow also. But we have to complete today portion. Is it clear? Yes. Okay. But I will tell. Don't worry. I will tell the group. Today I will tell the group. Now, next question. First. So I have shown a diagram to you. Now you can see QA is 14 centimeter, that is given. Okay. Now QR is equal to QA plus AR. QA is 14, QR is 21. Correct? So 21 is equal to 14 plus AR. 21 is equal to 14 plus AR. So 21 minus 14 is equal to AR. So AR is what? 7 centimeter. Okay. AR is what? 7 centimeter. Now we will find the area. Okay. Area of part Y. Theta upon 360 into pi R square. R I have taken capital. Okay. So area of a part Y is equal to theta upon 360 into pi R square. Theta is 90. So 90 upon 360 into 22 upon 7 into AR. AR is what? 7. So 7 square. Okay. So what will cancel? You understood now here? 7 into 7. So 1 7 will cancel. Correct? So what will remain? 1 upon 4 into 22 upon 7 into 7 into 7. Okay. Yes or no? So cancel 7 7. So what will remain? 1 upon 4 into 22 into 7. Correct? Multiply 22 into 7. We know the answer. What is 22 into 7? That is 154 divided by 4. Okay? 154 divided by 4. Or you can divide 22 by 2 and then multiply and then you divide by 2 again. No problem will come. Same answer will come. Okay. When we divide 154 by 4, we will get 38.5 centimeter square. Okay. Is it clear? Sure. All of you understood? 100%. Okay, good.